To breaking news this hour, 25 people have been arrested in raids across Germany on suspicion of plotting to overthrow the government. The people arrested embraced a fantasy based on conspiracy theories. A prince, judge and elite officer are among those arrested.
We have breaking news now. 25 people have been arrested in raids across Germany. They are suspected of plotting to overthrow the government.
Let's go live to Europe correspondent Brett McLeod, who is across this story. Brett, this is bizarre. An aristocrat is suspected to be the ringleader of this group.
Yeah, Tracy and David, that's right. It is bizarre and incredibly concerning as well. Amongst the 25 people arrested today was an aristocrat who was meant to head up a new government. That was the plan. It was an attempted coup, according to German police and other authorities. But the others arrested are equally concerning. A former judge and politician, and also current and former members of the military and police. That would explain why more than 100 raids across Germany, 3,000 police were involved. And as you can see, a lot of them were very heavily armed. They took this seriously. Now, the group itself is called Citizens of the Reich. The membership numbers in the thousands. It had been dismissed as a bit of a crackpot group, except it has been responsible for acts of violence, anti-Semitism and racism across Germany. And now this alleged plot to storm the Reichstag, the German parliament in Berlin, arrest MPs and then form their own shadow government modelled on the Second Reich back in 1871, which would see the return of the monarchy. In a sense, they felt life was a lot better then before World War I, and they wanted to try to restore that form of government. 25 people arrested so far, but more are expected to follow.
We know there's a big spike in far-right extremism, certainly across Europe, right across the world, but certainly across Europe. So where is this group getting its inspiration from? It's almost like January 6th is happening in Germany.
It does have those overtones, doesn't it, that those scenes we saw in Washington. And yes, Germany's interior minister had warned prior to this that far-right extremism is the country's greatest threat. And we do know that the sources are familiar. QAnon, the deep state conspiracy, seems to have fuelled the people behind this. As well as what is equally concerning, though, is that amongst the membership are those who are now sitting in Parliament. They're represented by a particular party in Germany who does have very strong right-wing views. And the question is, how much further did this plot go before it was uncovered? Now, thankfully, if all the allegations are proven true, it has been uncovered and will come to an end. But, of course, those conspiracies refuse to go away.
That's God, like what a self-declared prince. Yeah, judge?
And a judge.
How far reaching can this go?
Well, and it reaches to the upper echelons of society there, and of influence too. So it's extraordinary that they've had to take these measures, Brett.
Yeah, absolutely. And it does show that they know, or they felt this was enough to require such a large response across the country. Perhaps they're trying to send a message too to anyone else who's thinking of taking part in this form of plot, that you will be treated with the full force of the law. Because they're concerned that some of those who have been arrested were carrying weapons. And obviously, if there are military personnel involved, current serving military personnel involved, they have access to weapons too.
Wow, this could be the beginning of a lot going on in Germany. Yeah. We'll keep our eye on the story. Brett McLeod, thanks for having
me. Good to see you, Brett.
Ahead for you at 6, the Bali bombmaker walks free, having served just half of his sentence. And the victims are going to react live.
Plus, the tale of two...